For blue belts, the biggest thing that we want to work on is our courtesy and our manners. Now, a lot of kids come to us with different versions of courtesy and manners, and that's a powerful thing. We want to make sure that we fall in line with the ideals of your family. But at the same time, there are certain things that we definitely practice. For instance, being polite. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. No, thank you. Please. Those things are really important parts of our courtesy and our manners that we want to share every day when we're in our dojo. The other thing is we want to make sure that we're not arguing with each other or other people regarding things, and that we're starting to use kind words when we're responding. When we tell somebody that they're making an error or a mistake, we don't want them to say, no, that was bad. No, that was horrible. No, that was wrong. What we're trying to do is we're trying to give a positive sense of feedback and then kind of tell them also where they need to make that improvement. All we're doing is a mindset shift here. And we want to make sure that the students are starting to do that too. You'll notice in our school, you know, we give thumbs up a lot, but we don't ever give sideways thumbs or downways thumbs. We're trying to not put extra pressure on that element. Yes, is it important that they know that they need to grow? Of course. But sometimes showing it in certain ways doesn't give the student the best sense of security that they can actually grow from in our environment. We want to make sure they move forward from that. The other thing that they need to focus on, and they'll say it to you every single time, is stances, stances, stances. Our blue belt's biggest focus is going to be on their lower body work, identifying what proper stances are: ready stance, back stance, horse stance, and front stance. Those are our four primary stances that we use. And then, of course, our fighting stance that we use when we spar. Now, when they're showing these things, you can always go on the app to learn the extra details, but we want them to be able to distinguish between the width of a stance or which knee is bending properly, the back knee in a back stance, the front knee in a front stance. So those things are really powerful and they show up in our katas a lot. So we want to make sure that they're really focused and working on that before they go to the next level. If you feel like your student is meeting those requirements, then you go ahead and check the boxes and turn it in.